Welcome to my class. In this particular video session, we will make a comparative analysis of different cloud models which are available to us. We find that there are four cloud models. The first one is private cloud, the second one is public cloud, and the third one hybrid cloud, and the fourth one is community cloud. We will make a comparative analysis of all the four clouds. This comparative analysis will be based on number of factors. The first one is scalability. Scalability is the property of a system to handle a growing amount of work by adding resources to the system. If there is a need to have more resources, can we provide those more resources so that the work can be performed in the manner in which it is required? So scalability in case of private cloud, it is limited to the extent of resources deployed. It means it is not very easily scalable. But in the case of public cloud, the scalability level is very high. In the hybrid cloud as well, the scalability level is very high. But in the case of community cloud, the scalability level is limited. Second, on the basis of shared resources. In the case of private cloud, on-premise, no sharing with other organizations. The private cloud is on the premise of the user organization. It does not share with any other organization. So in this case, there is no sharing of resources. Whereas in the case of public cloud, it is a multi-tenant model. Here all resources are shared by public. In the case of hybrid cloud, resources in private cloud part are not shared, but in public cloud part are shared. In the case of community cloud, resources are shared among cooperatives. Those organizations are companies which belong to a particular set of community. In that case, they are termed as cooperatives. Third, faster deployment. The deployment period takes longer run as it requires trial runs for all operations in case of private cloud. So the deployment period is very long. In the case of public cloud, it offers instant facility to start cloud service. So for the user, there is no deployment time period. In the case of hybrid cloud, public part can be started immediately, whereas private part has longer deployment period. The deployment phase is similar to private cloud in case of community cloud. Fourth, on the basis of reliability, the reliability level is very high in case of private cloud. It is moderate in the case of public cloud. It is medium to high in case of hybrid cloud, and it is quite high in case of community cloud. Fifth, security. The security level is very high in case of private cloud. When we talk about public cloud, on the basis of security, it depends on the service provider. Hybrid cloud are considered to be secure. Community cloud are again secure. Sixth, performance level. The private cloud performance is considered good. Whereas public clouds are concerned, their performance level is considered from low to medium level. In hybrid cloud, performance level is considered good. In the community cloud, the performance level is considered to be very good. Seventh, initial cost of building data centers on service consumer. In the case of private cloud, the initial cost of building data center on the service consumer is very high. But in the case of public cloud, there is no cost at all. In the case of hybrid cloud, the initial cost of building data centers on service consumer is of medium in nature. In the case of community cloud, the initial cost of building data center on service consumer, it varies. It depends on the number of cooperatives. If the number of cooperatives are more, then initial cost can be shared and the burden is reduced among cooperatives. Operation and maintenance cost on provider. It is very high cost of data center in case of private cloud. In case of public cloud, low cost of data center. In the case of hybrid cloud, we take up the weighted average depending on the percentage of private part and the percentage of public part. If the percentage uses of private part is more, then operation and maintenance cost is on the higher side. If the percentage of public part is more, in that case, operation and maintenance cost on the provider is on the lower side. In the case of community cloud, it is similar to private cloud but distributed among participants, that is cooperatives. Ninth, size of data center. In the case of private cloud, it is considered to have ideal one if they are having around 5,000 servers. But in the case of public cloud, it can be around 50,000 servers. In the case of hybrid cloud, the size of data center is less than private cloud. But in the case of community cloud, the size of data center is more than private cloud but less than public cloud. 10th, on the basis of controllability. Private cloud has full control over its hardware and software. So full controllability is there in case of private cloud. In case of public cloud, limited configuration controllability. The user organization can ask to the service provider to provide this hardware and that software, but he has only limited say in the controllability. In case of hybrid cloud, there is full controllability over the private part and limited on public part. In community cloud, there is high controllability but limited by community policies. Trust level. Organization has a highest trust level in the private cloud because in that case data is considered to be very, very safe. In the public cloud, the trust level is quite low. In the hybrid cloud, trust level is mediocre in nature, that is medium. In the community cloud, the trust level is again high, but we can find highest level in private cloud. 12th, infrastructure location. In the case of private cloud, it is on-premise. The cloud is structured on the premise of the user organization itself. In case of public cloud, this is off-premise. Hybrid cloud is both on-premise and off-premise. In the case of community cloud, in general, we find infrastructure is located within the cooperative facility, within the cooperative members. 13th point, ownership of infrastructure. In the case of private cloud, it is the company, it is the user, it is the customer which owns all the infrastructure. In the case of public cloud, it is IaaS vendor, infrastructure as a service vendor, that is considered to be the ownership of the infrastructure. In the case of hybrid cloud, the customer owns the private cloud part and the IaaS vendor owns the public cloud part. In the case of community cloud, the ownership of infrastructure is shared among cooperatives. 14th, used by. Private cloud is used only by the internal employees of the company. In the case of public cloud, anyone can have access. In the case of hybrid cloud, there is medium accessibility. Community cloud, in that case, the infrastructure is used by the cooperative members. The use of infrastructure depends on the number of cooperatives. 15th point, service level agreements compliance. In the case of private cloud, there is possibility of loose service level agreements compliance because service provider and consumer are one and the same organization. In public cloud model, there is tendency towards strict service level agreements compliance. However, in the case of hybrid cloud, service level agreement compliances are moderate in nature. Whereas community cloud is concerned, with proper planning, service level agreements will surely meet compliances. So here there is need for good planning. 16th point, example. VMware and Microsoft Azure, these are the examples of private cloud. Public cloud, Google App Engine and Amazon EC2, these are the example of public cloud. Hybrid cloud, VMware, vCloud and Eucalyptus is an example of hybrid cloud. In the case of community cloud, we have VMware and Solas S. These are some of the companies which have provided their services in different cloud models. There can be many more points on the basis of which comparison can be made among all the four cloud models, but here it is not possible to go into the details of all those points. So we have restricted ourselves to the major points. Thank you very much.